Hey everyone, my name's Drew and we're here. This is going to be a brand new draft analysis for a brand new league that we're going to be taking part in, the Gallant Defenders League Season 2, the GDL Season 2. There's going to be a lot of really great people in it. I'm really excited about it. And there were a lot of different things going through my head in this new draft, right? So obviously, this is going to be a new experience for all of us. It's going to be one of the first DLC leagues that is going to be happening. And there's just so many new things coming out with this DLC that a lot of us are going to not really know how to draft and kind of the things we kind of want to do. But also, I ended up being, I believe, 12th out of 16th in this draft, which was not ideal for me, right? So it's obviously not early enough to get any super top tier mons early on, but also not late enough where you can get a reliable wheel. So order of operations is going to matter a whole heck of a lot, right? And ideally not get sniped, because no matter what, I'm going to have to wait a minimum of like 8 picks before it gets back to me. And a lot of people are going to be aiming for those cores. So I'm going to have to try to disrupt cores as much as I can and just make sure that I can get what I need, because the positioning is not ideal. But as always, we're going to do our best. I did pick on pick 12. And it was a really weird experience for me, because a lot of the top tier mons were gone. And honestly, Necrozma was there, obviously. And I ended up picking Necrozma, but I really felt weird about it, because there was one mon in particular that I really knew that I desperately wanted, right? I wanted to make sure that coming out of the DLC, I came up with this mon no matter what happened. And I felt like having Necrozma on my team might in some ways interfere with that. I've just drafted Necrozma a whole bunch of times, so I know I'm going to get memed on for that. It's going to be fine. But I really wanted to kind of build out a team that could work around this one mon that I was after in the middle tiers. Necrozma was just the best mon on board. I love using Necrozma. I feel like I can use it decently well. And honestly, I've never even used Necrozma since it got access to Dragon Dance. So that's going to be a ton of fun. I feel like Necrozma just offers any team just so much in terms of what it can do. And I had to pick it up, even though, like I said, I've picked it so many times. But it's just so freaking great. I adore this mon to death. We got Necrozma with the number one pick. There's really not much to say about it, right? Like, it just does everything, right? It can Dragon Dance up now. It can Autotomize. It can Calm Mind up. It can be a defensive wall. It can set up rocks. It just, like, does everything. Like, I don't know what else I could say about it. I'm just going to move on and see whatever the heck I can do to kind of pair mons up with this. And so now at this stage, right, not only are a lot of really top-tier mons gone, but also the top tier of G-Maxes are going. Now, this is going to be a G-Max format, which is really not ideal for me, right? I don't like this G-Max form. I don't like G-Max formats in general. It also gets super awkward when they can't hold items. So a lot of interesting mons that would be super duper interesting get a little bit less so without items, right? So I have to think about that as well. And with that in mind, I really don't like my chances of being able to get a good G-Max on the way back, right? Like, if I let a G-Max go, I still feel like it's too early for me to get a G-Max, and I would have preferred to kind of like build a better core around this team. But with the likelihood of G-Max is getting taken away early, and I feel like the hard limit on how many good G-Maxes were out and available, I felt like I had to pull the trigger right now on a G-Max that might be a little bit expensive. It doesn't cost any points, but it doesn't give it any either. It might be a little bit expensive for what it is, but I will be picking up G-Max Cinderace. Now, G-Max Cinderace is a brand new G-Max, and I was talking about it with Leo, 6 Foot Hacks, one of the creators of the league, and obviously it sucks that Cinderace wouldn't be able to hold items, but it's a really solid fire type. He was saying, yeah, Cinderace might be not as good without access to heavy duty boots. But I told him, look, I've drafted it once, and it was one of the most fun mods I've ever used. And I almost never brought it without just a band, because a banded Cinderace just was so fast. It was so good. It hit so hard. You could U-turn in and out. And it was so much fun to use. And I would like to think that it's going to translate a lot more with this G-Max Cinderace. And also just things like being able to airstream up, being able to knuckle up, and its new G-Max move, I believe G-Max Fireball, ignores abilities. So like Necrozma, this pairing of Necrozma and Cinderace are going to ignore abilities when they attack, when the user signature attacks, and just a lot that I think that this G-Max Cinderace can offer me that I think is going to be a lot of fun to use. And if it's even like half as fun as it was just to bring banded Cinderace every gosh dang week to the last time that I drafted it, I will enjoy the heck out of this pick. But now it's been a whole bunch of picks have gone by, and it's coming back to me. I really don't know what I want to take. So honestly, Mid kind of took a pick of mine that I really wanted. I really wanted the pairing of Rotom Wash and G-Max Cinderace. Honestly, it's something that I probably would have done if I didn't feel like I had to pull the trigger early on G-Max Cinderace. Or I had to pull the trigger on Necrozma, because obviously Necrozma, I don't think Necrozma would have come back to me. And it was something that I really needed to get because it was just the best value on board, bar none, in my opinion. And I just had to get it, right? I lost out on that Rotom pairing. And I was looking at good electric types. I really couldn't find anything that I really vibed with that hard. So I ended up picking up Dracozolt. Now Dracozolt is a really weird pick, right? So it's gonna give me a dragon type, so it does resist it, like it is decently bulky. It will be able to kind of fill in some roles as like as a bulkier mon to kind of take a handful of hits here and there, but it just hits really, really hard as an electric type. And my main goal with this pick was to not only just get an electric type, but to get an electric type that really punishes bulky waters, right? Because I wanted to be able to punish bulky waters, open the door for G-Max Cinderace. And honest to God, I believe that G-Max Cinderace can be one of those mons that can finish off games on its own. And so can Dracozolt, right? So Dracozolt and Cinderace just feel like they pair up really well together. I feel like Dracozolt is kind of out of my style and like not something that I would normally do in most situations, but I feel like they just pair really well together, and I feel like they could do a lot for each other. And with that, I'll just get into the next pick, which is indeed Email. Okay, so this is the pick that from the beginning, from before the draft even started, I knew I wanted this mon above all others, and it's one of the only things that really kind of dissuaded me from wanting to get this Necrozma, because I felt like they might have clashed a little bit. It's a second psychic type. They're gonna have some common weaknesses. Obviously this one's immune to ghost, but it's gonna share the dark and the bug weakness, which is never gonna be great. And good dark types might, you know, be a problem for my team, right? So I'm gonna have to think about that moving forward. But Indeedee, with Psychic Terrain and Expanding Force, I think Expanding Force could be the absolute sleeper of this entire post-DLC meta, and I'm really excited to use it. I'm really excited to kind of mess around with it. I think it plus Necrozma could do so many things together, and even just setting up terrain for things like Dracozolt, a Scarf Dracozolt where nothing can use priority against it, it's going to be a whole lot of fun. I believe in Indeedee. I'm just a little bit concerned about maybe it potentially clashing with Necrozma, but I love Necrozma too much, and I believe in Indeedee too much to kind of not want to pair them together. So we're going to see how this goes. I don't know exactly how this season's going to turn out, but I think overall this draft looks super fun to me. I'm picking pieces that I think will play well together, that I think are going to be a lot of fun to use together. And with that, I gotten in the next pick, Supreme Arena. Okay, Supreme Arena is a pick, right? I was showing my draft to multiple people, right? Because I thought I had the beginnings of like somewhat of a spicy draft, and multiple people, two people like completely independent of each other, told me, you know what pick would be perfect for you when it comes back around? Primarina. Dr. Slacking was one of them. Dr. Slacking's wonderful, wonderful coach, wonderful creator. But him, I talked to a lot throughout this entire drafting process, and I really respect his opinion a lot. He told me Primarina, and somebody else did. And again, Primarina is another mon where it's like, I'm going to get meme for it because I know I drafted this mon a whole heck of a lot. And I don't think I've drafted any mon more than Necrozma, probably. I'd have to look into that, but probably. It just like matched my team really well. It gives me more of a core going on. It breaks for a lot of what I needed to break for, right? It's a somewhat bulky water that doesn't, you know, lose to grasses or bulky waters, right? It can Moonblast into bulky waters and bulky grass, both typings that are going to really help out Dracozolt and or Cinderace. It can help me out with the dark situation. Obviously, it resists bug as well, so it helps me out in that scenario as well. And it can just put out massive amounts of damage. I really like using Primarina. It's always been a ton of fun to use. But with that, I don't know. I'm just going to get into the next pick, which is another mon that I'm going to get memed on so hard. But it's a mon that I felt I needed, right? Serena, I think, is wonderful. I love the heck out of using Serena. And Serena's been a part of multiple playoff runs, but it's just so much fun to use. And my favorite Serena set by far is just a Scarf Serena that can U-turn in and out. It hits so hard. Power Rip just genuinely hits hard. And it opens the door so well. It creates mismatches, just straight up matchup issues for my opponents. And I just love the way that it interacts with most teams. And I think it just offers up so much more than a generic grass type. I think it is so, so good and is very, very underrated. But I love having it a part of this overall kind of team that I'm building here. with that next is Obsidian. And Obsidian's a mon that I got my first taste of. Well, I mean, honestly, if I want to be real, I got my first taste of it in the UBL when Vepsis had it. And just the way that Vepsis used it was so good, and it really opened my eyes to how good Obsidian could be. That's just another fantastic creator. But then after that, I got to use it a little bit in the TBL, the Team Battle League, with my partner in Baby Color, and it was fantastic. I loved using it, like, genuinely. It was so much fun to use. It was one of the most fun mons that I've used. I didn't know that Leo wanted this. It sucks that I wanted it too, but man, I really needed a dark type. Another ghost immune is huge for me in the grand scheme of things, but as a dark type, it was honestly one of the best, most fun mons that was on board. I think I looked like pretty much through everything, and it was just one of the most fun mons that I could imagine picking up in this moment. And with that, I got a wheezing. So here's another mon that I really needed for kind of a defensive core, and I definitely needed certain typings here, right? So here's a situation where I desperately wanted not to lose to fairies, because I am developing a little bit of a fairy weakness, and I really need to not lose to a strong fairy here. But in particular, my Obsidian and my Dracozolt can be problematic. Obviously, Cinderace can resist, but it's not like it's hitting it back that hard. So I really need something that can wall it out, that can kind of create sort of mismatches. It gives me a strong defensive presence, access to toxic spikes, which is going to be huge. Overall, it just offers my team a whole heck of a lot that I really need in this moment. And it does feel like a little bit of a boring pick. It feels like a necessary pick, though. And it also, it's another reunion. That Obstagoon Weezing pairing coming back from the TBL with Invivid Color again. And I'm just really excited to get to use them again together. I think they interact really well together. With that, I'm going to get into the next pick. So Sandslash. Okay, so here is where I really aggressively started getting sniped. My last three picks, which these are my final three picks, were all direct snipes. And they all happened like right before I was about to take the mon that I desperately, desperately wanted to kind of build out my team. This mon was meant to be him on top. And in the grand scheme of things, I really don't mind this snipe at all, right? I really like Sandslash. I've only drafted this thing once, but the one time that I did use it, I really enjoyed using it. I thought it was a fantastic pick for the value that it gave me, and just the value in terms of where it is tiering wise is generally really good. I really like it just as a generic ground type. It can set up rocks. I believe now it gets access to spikes, which Leo is throwing multiple times at this point. It can spin. Overall, Hypnotop adding a fighting type might have been a little bit more beneficial to the team. I think a fighting type would have helped me out a decent amount here. But if I'm not gonna get Hypnotop, I think this is a really, really solid pickup. No matter what, I don't think I could have gone wrong with either. I just like Sandslash too much to really complain about getting sniped about Hypnotop. Although it does stink that I got sniped on Hypnotop, and it's going to put me on tilt because I did get sniped again out of my next pick, which was meant to be, I just mentioned this really quickly before I get to the pick, it was meant to be Scyther, right? I thought Scyther gave me so much here. It gives me strong bug stab, strong U-turn, right? A strong flying type that can do a wing beat. It gives me fighting resist, another ground immunity, which I really need as many ground immunities as I can manage. It gives me a bunch of immunities. I need a flying type. I need just strong U-turn, bulk in general, defog. It gives me so many things that that felt like I needed. And with that, I get into my next pick, which is Rotom Frost. Okay, now, Rotom Frost is a weird one, there's no doubt. But my thought process here was, and I thought about this a lot, like I gave this a lot of thought. I came to multiple people, Dr. Slagging and Leo, primarily, right? And my main argument was, so I have drafted Rotom Heat in the past, right? And obviously Rotom Heat is a ton better. But whenever I actually brought Rotom Heat into matches, two of its move slots were always Defog and Will-O-Wisp, and generally speaking, the other slots were generally like some combination of like sub toxic or pain split or some kind of combination of all these like status moves. I rarely ever even brought Overheat, and I believe I only clicked Overheat like once or twice at most, like the entire season that I used Rotom Heat in. So here's an opportunity where I felt like I could get most of what I would have gotten out of Scyther. I still get Defog. I still get a ground immunity. I can kind of status certain things. I can still Volt Switch in and out. Can still do a number of things for me. But obviously the typing's worse. Obviously being able to have super effective damage on dark types and, you know, losing out on a fighting resist is not ideal here. At the very least, this gives me a lot of things that I can use, and being able to Volt Switch in and out
kind of discourages bulky water types, which again is going to be huge for my Cinderace. The more that this combination of Dracozolt and Rotom Frost can kind of discourage bulky waters from just doing whatever they want to do, feel like really helps me out here. And as well as the Serena, I just think that this combination of mons just helps, just supports Cinderace as much as possible. And like I said, I just think Cinderace can win games on its own with the right opportunity to get G-Max moves off or D-Max moves off. And with that, the final snipe, I really wanted Alolan Dugtrio. Now, Alolan Dugtrio is a tier 5 mon, obviously. My last mon to pick up is a tier 5 mon, but I felt like Alolan Dugtrio gave me so much value for what I wanted. And I should also mention that Alolan Dugtrio was always going to be, was always in my plan for my final four picks. And that's why I was mildly upset that I couldn't get Hitmontop, because my plan was to have Hitmontop be my fighting type and my main ground type to be Alolan Dugtrio. It might have been weird to have Alolan Dugtrio and Sandslash on the same team and just have like dual ground types, but it's only because that Hitmontop got sniped for me. Regardless, Alolan Dugtrio gives me a steel type, a ground type, it gives me rocks, it gives me that 110 speed tier, which is perfect for my team. It slots right in between Obstagoon at 95 and Cinderace at 119. It would have been the perfect speed tier for me. And I really just like Alolan Dugtrio in general, right? Like, I've won a championship with Alolan Dugtrio, and I really just thought Alolan Dugtrio was fun to use. It might not fit the scene that well, especially as a main steel type, but either way, that's what I got sniped out of in the final round. Vepsis sniped it for me, and I'm still mildly upset about it, but we ended up picking up Noctowl. Now, Noctowl does give me another ghost immunity. It gives me a flying type, which I desperately needed. It gives me, obviously, another ground immunity. And now I have a ton of ground immunities. I had much more ground immunities going this route than I did in my original route. So, I don't know. This might end up working better for me. Who knows? But Noctowl just seems really fun to use. My first real exposure to it in a real, like, competitive context was against TTM, Jolt, and Goldoa in the Team Battling League, and it almost beat Josh and I, our entire team, right? So this thing with Tinted Lens is really strong. Blunder Policy, Hypnosis, Blunder Policy, Hurricane. If I get a free turn, I can Nasty Plot off. And Hurricane Tinted Lens just does so much damage to everything. This is a pickup that I really think is gonna be able to do some things. Even just like crazy sets. I mean, it can be like a Roost sub Calm Mind set. I don't know. There's so many opportunities for Noctowl to do certain things in certain matchups, and who knows how often it'll come. But it's gonna be a lot of fun to use. And in honesty, I did get super upset about my final four picks, but in truth, I'm really happy about the first like half of my draft. So honestly, if the biggest thing that I'm kind of complaining about is my final four picks, then I feel like that's a good problem to have. And I feel like my team is a little bit less well-rounded with this kind of route that I had to go down, but I think I can kind of take this first half of my team to do so many things. It just covers so many boxes that I need to have checked, and I'm really excited about how this team can function together. But with that, that's going to be the New Jersey Robats for Season 2 of the GDL. This was an incredibly, incredibly exciting team to put together. It's going to be a really fun season. And like I said, I feel like I have so many pieces that fit well together, even though I'd give up a little bit of cohesion to kind of make it all work. But I truly, truly believe in the top half of my draft. And it's going to do so many things. I'm really excited about it. But with that, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll be back really, really soon with more weeks of the GDL coming up really, really soon. I've already had my first round battle, and there's going to be so many fun battles coming in the near future. And another draft analysis coming really, really soon for another league that I'm also really excited about. But with that, once again, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll be back again. Out.